expands to the issues and concerns that we have.
GM is a superstar because everyone in the team really counts.
Hi, good morning again. This is our 36th episode sa ating online kapihan sa BLGF7, and we are streaming live every Monday at 10 o'clock in the morning. Hi po sa mga suki namin dyan sa Luzon, Visayas at saka sa Mindanao. Tuloy-tuloy lang ang pagpanood natin sa ating mga topical discussions dito sa ating online kapihan sa BLGF7. Ito po ay related naman po sa ating trabaho sa Treasury and Assessment Works Operations sa LGU at saka Operations ng Local Government Unit as a whole. Ladies and gentlemen, walang patumpik-tumpik. Puntahan po natin ang ating Regional Director kasi as I understand, he is invited as one of the speakers doon sa isang pagpupulong doon na regarding agricultural sector yata. About valuation pa rin. Ladies and gentlemen, our Regional Director, Director JC Joy Doc Tolero. Good morning, RD.
Good morning, Torrance. Good morning, everyone. Maing buntag, mga ka-assessor, mga treasurer din sa Central Visayas. It's another beautiful Monday morning. So despite and in spite of the clear and present danger of COVID-19, still BLGF7 staying afloat, still focus not on the load, on our problems we carry, but on the weapon, on how to fight for it. Okay, let us strengthen ourselves by boosting our immunity, observe the health protocols, and most of all, pray for more. So walang ibang weapon to combat COVID-19, but of course, we have to pray hard. Okay. So today, for today's episode, Attorney Tanieka will be discussing on why on the right of the homeowners to regulate the passage into their subdivision for security purposes. Just consider also the right of the LGU to close and open roads. So what are you waiting? What are you waiting for, mga ka-treasurers, mga ka-assessors? Type nyo na yung mga comment nyo, your sent of thoughts, and your questions to the comment box. So once again, thank you for always joining us and for supporting our online kapihan sa BLGF7. Consulta kay Atty. God bless and thank you.
Ardi, before we let you go, Ardi, we'd like to announce that you already have your second dose at saka 2 weeks after you are now considered as fully vaccinated. Eh, wala na yata mga restrictions sa travel pag fully vaccinated. Yes. Congratulations, RD!
Thank you, Torrance. But still, we have, despite na fully vaccinated, we still to follow the health protocols by wearing masks and so on and so forth. Because I understand medyo ang Cebu ngayon is tumaas yung kaso. So let us protect ourselves. Na rin. Yes, let us protect our neighbors, our office mate, and all of us. Okay, so thank you, Torrance, and I will leave you.
Adi, for the pride of Region 7, Adi, mind sharing what this invitation of your speakership about? Adi, magiging proud tayo kasi galing Region 7, director pa natin yung iniiminta nila, and this is not from Treasury and Assessment Group. This is coming from what sector yung invitation, Adi?
Yes, from the Department of Agriculture. We have the training on the evaluation of agricultural and fisheries mechanization and infrastructure projects. This is a training of trainers for the Bureau of Agriculture and Fisheries Engineering, the BAFE.
And that is happening now, ngayon, after this opening message of yours, you are going straight directly to that invitation, are they?
Yes, so we will be joining them with Director Gilbert Gumabay, the Regional Director of region 2 and 9. So for my slot, I will be taking the discussion for today and tomorrow.
Okay.
And Director Gilbert will be for Wednesday and Friday.
So we'll have to excuse you, Adi, with this kapihan, Adi. So make us proud, Adi. We are very proud of you as one of the speakers for the said event, Adi. Thank you, Adi. Okay, on that note, ipapakikilala ko rin, i-introduce ko na rin yung aking co-host. Ayan, kasi I cannot help but notice, is it the makeup or talagang bumabata si Miss Joan Anabidel? Ladies and gentlemen, ang aming tagapag-alaga sa amin, sa aming kapakanan, ang aming chief ng Treasury Division, si Miss Joan Anabidel. Nay, good morning, Nay, pasok!
Good morning, everybody. Mayong buntag sa tanan, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao.
Who is doing your makeup today, Nay? Who is doing your makeup? Yung hair and makeup mo?
The brand, si Ate Brand.
Ah, so she must have really done a good work. Look at you.
Ah,
yes. Your as ever.
Oh.
Yeah, and this is second dose na Nay, or first dose pa lang?
Magsi-second dose pa lang po.
Good. Go ahead, Nay. Yung mga pag-greetings mo, wala pa yata tayong mga online streamer, pero if you have greetings for the your focal, yung mga champions mo, mag-iingat sila din po.
Ingat-ingat na tayo kasi ito nabasa ko sa chat na parang ito, napuno na naman ang mga hospital.
Yeah.
Ingat po tayo. Yeah. So don't forget yung mag-wear ng face mask. Facing at saka hugas ng kamay at saka pinaka-importante po yung social distancing. Iwahiwalay muna tayo.
Oh. Don't be complacent. Sabi nga ni RD, miski naturukan na tayo, don't have that sense of complacency. Health protocols pa rin.
Wala talaga. Hindi talaga tayo dapat walang wag ipawalang bahala.
Yan.
Kasi andyan pa rin siya.
Go ahead na.
Sabi po ni Geraldine Tabangay Tan from El Nido, Palawan. Good morning. Kay Seth Caballero. Online siya ngayon. Kang Jen Carpentera. Kay Junitasa. Si Ma Franca Oira, ang Assistant City Treasurer ng Dumaguete City. Kay Mark Rinden ng San Simon, Pampanga. Kay Emma Go at saka kay Sarah Jade. So meron na tayo from Pampanga and from Palawan.
Lido, Palawan. Mga early streamers natin. Nay, thank you, Nay. Balikan kita mamaya for mga pa-comment at sa mga pa-shoutouts natin dyan sa ating comment section. Thank you. That was Miss Joan Anabelli, ang ating chief ng Treasury Division. And before we go ahead with that topical discussion today, iuna ko lang muna po dito po sa Cebu City. We are back to 3 digits. Ayan. Top news of the week that matters. Back to 3 digits po yung mga new positive cases dito sa Cebu. Cebu City back to 3-digit new cases. Ayan. First news of the week that matters. And yun nga. The country now detects 55 new Delta variant cases. 94 new Alpha cases. Variant. At saka 9 P.3 variant infections according to the Department of Health. Yan, hindi ko alam kung ano yung ibang variant, pero meron palang mga ganun. Because of this, tougher restrictions are eyed amid the Delta threat, sabi ng Pangulo in a public address last Monday. He said that stricter restrictions should be are to be imposed to curb the spike of this Delta variant. At ayan na nga, nangyari na nga. In CR, I guess Metro Manila is on GCQ. Balik uli doon sa heightened restrictions. At saka binawi rin po yung previous IATF resolution na nag-allow ng 5 years old app na gumala sa labas. Ngayon po, hindi na rin po pwede dahil nga doon sa threat ng new cases of Delta variant. Another top news of the week. In a related matter, the President Rodrigo Duterte has ordered the LGUs and the Philippine National Police to implement existing protocols with greater urgency and necessity in the face of the threat posed by the Delta variant. Ayan. With greater urgency and necessity inatasan po ng ating Pangulo yung local government units at saka yung mga kapulisan natin to implement the existing health protocols with great urgency and necessity dahil nga doon sa Delta variant. Ngayong hapon po pala ay magkakaroon ng state of, ngayon ba yung hapon? July 26. Oo, ngayon hapon yata. Ayan, magkakaroon ng state, panghuling state of the nation address ng ating Pangulo. And sabi po ng taga-Pangasiwa na si doon sa PTV4, si Castro, the theme for the Zona World program would be Mindanawan. Mindanawan theme for the Zona program. It would be something classy, simple, modest, and yet impactful. Biggest challenge therefore, sabi ng ating taga-Pangasiwa sa State of the Nation, ang biggest challenge lang is to put a cap doon sa number of attendees kasi limited yung number of attendees. Only 395 names are invited and must go to submit a negative COVID-19 result taken 48 hours before the event. At saka upon arrival at the Batasang Pambansa, guests will undergo another test. Yan, pangalawang test ng COVID-19. Ganyan ka-strikto. And sabi ng ating Philippines PSG Security Group, Presidential Security Group, the President will have a 360 security shield para to neutralize any kind of threat. Kasama na po dyan ang COVID-19 variant case. Yan, ngayong hapon na po yan yung State of the Nation address ng ating Pangulo to have a Mindanawang theme. In a good news, according to the Department of Finance, particularly si Undersecretary Hill is Beltran, the peso, yung currency po natin, remains one of the strongest in Asia. Sabi ni Yusik Hill Beltran, the peso was the least volatile currency among the Asian countries. Least volatile daw. Hindi yata tayo nakasandig lang. So sa Tagal, sa Bisaya pa sandig, sa mga foreign currencies. Ayan. Now ito, in another news, which will be the subject of our discussion, a related subject of our discussion for today. Ito. Posted on Manila Standard last July 20 yata to, at saka sa ibang pahayagan sa nandoon sa online platform nila. Guardhouses as toll booths were demolished. The Quezon City Department of Public Order and Safety demolished several guardhouses in private subdivisions that were collecting tolls. Yan. Guardhouses were considered, according to the Department of Public Order and Safety of Quezon City, guardhouses were considered as road obstruction. And the DPOS chief po nila sa DPOS said their operation will continue against illegal guardhouses even if they are inside private subdivision. Sabi ni Mayor Belmonte ng Quezon City, we do not tolerate private subdivision that take advantage of motorists just because they have to pass their gates. These lanes are public roads and no one should be paying amounts for them. Sabi ng Mayor, ni Mayor Belmonte, road safety is a shared responsibility and we must refrain from obstructing such public roads. So yun na nga, yun yung topical discussions natin ngayon. The right discussion natin ngayon, the right of the private subdivision homeowners to security by placing security measures, yung mga guardhouses, yung mga regulations into entrance and exit of these private subdivisions, versus the right of the LGUs to open roads, to yung sabi ni Mayor Pimente, shared responsibility yun, yung walang obstruction sana yung road. So first of course, Yung issue na public road ba ito? Yung mga private subdivision roads? O kung private man, sinong may karapatan? May karapatan ba ang LGU na buksan ang mga subdivisions? Parallel doon sa ginawa ng Quezon City Government, sinira po yung mga guardhouses. Kasi sabi ng Quezon City Government, these are obstruction to roads. Nabanggit lang. Sabi, public roads daw yun within the subdivision. So, which is which talaga? So, would you like to return on that? Teka muna ha? Wala pa yata ang mga pa-shoutouts si Miss John Anabelia. Hey, kung may pa-shoutouts ka, pasok lang for us to have a break. So, kung wala, tuloy-tuloy na rin ako sa aking discussion. Ayan, wala pa yata. Si Cesar Sabas pala of Danao, City Assessor of Danao. Good morning, sir. Ayan, kabandmate ko. Si Ma'am Opone sa Sibunga. Ayan. So, tuloy-tuloy na tayo sa ating topical discussion of the episode. Ang 36 episode na po namin ito. Hopefully, you can see my screen now. Ayan. Now, paano ba yung atake natin dito sa topical discussion na ito? So, I will not center my discussion on the actual demolition of Quezon City kasi baka mayroong pending case dyan or baka mayroong maghahabla tungkol dyan. I will, however, discuss an existing case about a related matter, hindi talaga at four squares or at all fours yung mga nangyayari dito sa case na i-discuss ko. However, mayroon tayong mapupulot again for our navigation process na rin. We know how to navigate kung tayo po ay presented with ganito na situation. Again, our issue of the week of the episode is sino bang pumapaibabaw? Yun ho bang karapatan ng subdivision homeowners sa security, peace and order? Ay, good morning pala kay Engineer Glenn Balasabas. Ayan, yung kabanda ko rin, yung municipal assessor ng Tayasan, Negros Oriental. So, sino bang mangibabaw? Yun bang karapatan ng private subdivision to have a security sa entry at passage nila sa kanilang subdivision? O yun ho bang karapatan ng LGUs to close and open roads? Sabi nga ni Mayor Belmonte, para tanggalin yung mga obstruction. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, this is bago-bago lang kasi wala pa tayong survey sa 2020. The year that was, gawin rin natin. 2019 po ito na case na ito. For the interest of parties involved, para hindi masubject to unnecessary exposure, I will cite the case na lang ng GR number niya at saka the date it was promulgated. It is GR number. Available po ito sa website, official website ng ating Supreme Court of the Philippines. It is promulgated as, ito po yung citation, GR number 211353, dated June 10, 2019. Yan, tuloy-tuloy na po tayo. To provide a factual antecedents, parang backgrounder, para maintindihan natin kung anong nangyari sa case nito before we go to decision. These are what was happening before this was decided by the Supreme Court. There is an existing subdivision kasi, residential subdivision located in one LGU. Again, hindi muna natin mention yung LGU. It is a residential subdivision. However, doon po sa residential subdivision na po na yon, mayroong several commercial establishments operating within it. Commercial within a residential subdivision. May ganun. Ipapakita natin yung picture mamaya. Kasi this is taken from the internet na credits to the owner, whoever are the owner of these pictures. Google map yata natin ito nakuha. Kasi sa Google map, mayroong road view. Road view yata yun. Yung mga commercial establishment ito include bear houses. Remember, residential subdivision, mayroong bear houses, karaoke bars, nightclubs, and other drinking joints. Ay, hindi namin alam ni Engineer Glenn at saka ni Cesar yan. Ano yung mga nightclubs na yan? Yung mga drinking joints, hindi namin alam. Hindi namin kabisado kasi hanggang chapel at saka church lang kami ni Engineer Glenn at saka ni Cesar. So, for give me if hindi ko masyadong ma-describe kung ano itong mga nightclubs. Ayan. So, because of this, patrons, customers, and many other freely people freely come and out the subdivision. Yan, mahirap. Ay, sorry. Imagine, residential subdivision, mayroong commercial establishment. Yung commercial establishments, mga beer houses, karaoke bars, at nightclubs pa naman. So, miski sino-sino yung pumapasok kasi nga mayroong mga nightclubs. Ewan ko kung nagala si Engineer Glenn at si CSR doon. Kasi baka may chapel din doon at saka church. So, yan. Sa Luzon yata itong subdivision na ito. So, such unrestricted access daw to the subdivision exposed its residents to incidents of robbery. Ayan, security concerns na. Akyat bahay. Prostitution. Rape. Ito, hindi biro to. May rape daw. Loud music, kasi nga, beer houses, karaoke bars, nightclubs. Noise that would last even until the wee hours of the morning. Lalong hindi bagay sa amin itong mga commercial establishment ito. Kasi si Engineer Glenn natutulog yan, 8 o'clock pa lang. Si Cesar, mga 9 o'clock. Ito, mga until the wee hours of the morning yung mga noise. So the Homeowners Resident Association doon sa subdivision na yon, to address the concern, the peace and security issues raised by the, and they raise it to the City Council of the LGU. Ayan, nagpapatulong po yung mga homeowner subdivision doon sa residential subdivision na yan kasi ang ingay daw. So imagine that, ladies and gentlemen, ano kayang dapat gawin ng LGU? So, first of all, of course, may karapatan pa si LGU mag-address, mag-regulate sa passage doon, considering that this is a private subdivision. Pangalawa, ano pong magagawa ng subdivision mismo? Kung, for example, kabaliktaran ito kasi doon sa Quezon City, sila yung sumira doon sa mga guardhouses, nag-demolish. Dito, pwede bang mag-install ng mga guardhouses yung subdivision? And this time, would the LGU would react to that? So kabaliktaran yung nangyari dito. Sabi ko nga, hindi at all force yung narrative dito. So, dito, gusto ng private subdivision na mag-interfere yung LGU. So ano po yung kahihinatnan dito? So ladies and gentlemen, kung mayroon kayong idea, comment na po dyan sa aming comment section. Sa mga pa-shoutout dyan sa ating comment section na rin, pwede rin. So ponder on that. It's a case of peace and orders or security concern ng subdivision seeking assistance to the LGU. Yeah. How would we attack this? So, in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have a break and puntahan po natin yung mga pa-comment at sa mga pa-shoutout dyan sa ating comment section. Pasay!
Hello! Magandang umaga uli sa ating mga viewers. Isang malakas na sigaw palabas po para kay Handayan Linlin from Maso, Kandihay, Bohol. Kay Kilo Kasuna ng Dalaguet, Cebu. Kay Brooke Tulibong Pase Terrino, the City Assembly Office of Coleto City. Shout out po kay Hunsoy ni Inko Hias ng LGU Bulacan. Kay Julie Santos. Kay Yudisa Rakatag ng Tramsor. Kay Daniel Nesta, isa rin po siyang kapitan. Kay Arsenia Paik. Moving on pa rin sa ating sigaw palabas, kay Rosien Mantalaba. Good morning, PLG Everything 7. This is from Minglanilla, Cebu, Municipal Treasurer's Office. Sigaw palabas po para kay Bernadette Timonio, kay Annette Vero, kay John Dizon, who is watching from State of Emirates. Oh, John Dizon. At saka kay Erised Gabison Risma. Shout out to LGU Minglanilla. At Ate Bren, thank you sa makeup.
Thank you, Nay. Thank you. I'll get back to you later on, Nay. So, in the meantime, ponder on that, ladies and gentlemen, yung ating factual antecedents ng ating Supreme Court. Sabi na doon sa factual antecedent, mayroong isang residential subdivision, mayroong commercial establishment doon, bar houses, videoke, mga nightclubs, ayan. So they seek the assistance of the NGO kasi may security concerns sila. Ito, kabalik na rin. May security concerns sila dahil nga ang daming robbery daw, ang daming mga nangyayari. Hopefully you can see my screen, ha? Baka naman kasi I'm not sharing my screen. Yan, balik. If I'm not sharing my screen, paki-shout out po. Ayan, naka-monitor naman po ang ating production team manager, si Mr. Jolis Panoy. Congratulations kay Mr. Jolis Panoy. You know what? It's game over. Ayan, nakapost sa kanyang Facebook page kung ano yung momentos, momentos event sa buhay ni Mr. Jolis Panoy. Ayan. Ayan, uy, kinilig ako. Mayroong nag-greet sa ating regional director, si Barry Misabi na, "Good morning, Adik. Keep safe always." Yeah, yung first day at ng ating regional director. Yeah, keep safe daw, Ardi, sabi ng ating may bahay. And good morning din kay Ma'am ID May Pahente Electronaya. Yes, yeah, the municipal assessor of Santa Catarina. Ma'am, good morning, ma'am. How's your program going? Diba, mayroon din silang podcast or radio program kay Sir Cirilo Amazona. Yan, tuloy-tuloy po tayo doon sa ating topical discussion of the episode. Now, ayun na nga. So, upon seeking assistance to the council on February 24, 2003. Ayan. The City Council of this LGU issued an Ordinance number 132, series of 2003. This time, ano yung ginawa ng LGU? Reclassifying the subdivision. Sorry, hindi naka-voice over. Ayan. Reclassifying the subdivision as exclusively residential. Nag-approve yung LGU ng isang ordinansa reclassifying the LGU as subdivision as residential, and therefore prohibiting the further establishment and operation of any business except for those already existing. Ganun pa rin. Kasi may existing bar nightclubs na doon. However, this ordinance was not complied with as more warehouses and nightclubs were still put up. Mas dumami daw. Buti kung merong mga chapel sana kasi yun yung pupuntahan ni Cesar at saka ni Engineer Glenn. Eh ngayon, mas dumami pa yung nightclubs at saka beer gardens. Ano ba yung mga yan? May mga idea ba kayo kung ano yung nightclubs at saka beer garden? Kasi enlighten us, kasi ignorante kami sa ganyan. Sabi daw yung nightclub kasi mayroong patay sindi doon. Eh, kulang yata ng kuryente kasi patay sindi yung mga ilaw nila. Ayan. The peace and order situation and security therefore in subdivision this did not improve. And among those affected was a resident, si tawagin natin, itago na natin sa pangalang Mr. K, ayan, or Mr. M, anong gusto nyo. Sabihin na natin si Julius, oh, si Julius muna. So among those affected was Julius, ayan, alias lang muna. He is a resident of this subdivision for more than 38 years. And however, he also has a commercial establishment. Ayan, bakit ako nag... ayan, may incoming text pala. He also have a commercial establishment. Ayan, galing ng isa, may text talaga. Galing ng isang internet provider. Hi, we have fixed the issue affecting your home internet connection. Buti na lang, kanina pa. Oh, unplug daw. And refresh your connection. Eh, mag-unplug ako, naka-livestream kami sa aming Facebook. Mamaya na po, internet provider, ako mag-unplug sa aking router. Ayan. So, si Mr. Residential Subdivision, resident doon sa residential subdivision, eh, mayroon din palang motels doon. So, he is also operating a commercial establishment doon sa residential subdivision. So, seeking to address his security concern, si Mr. Julius proposed nga maglagay sila ng guard post doon sa residential subdivision nila at saka security. So under this policy, the visitors on vehicles also to enter the premises must leave with the subdivision guards their ID, and they may reclaim this upon leaving the subdivisions. However, those visitors on foot are not required to surrender this. So meanwhile, The residents with vehicles may obtain stickers to identify themselves so that they do not need to surrender their card. Now, after their consultations and meetings, the policy was approved in 2006 and a memorandum was later issued to take effect those what was agreed. Ito po yung residential subdivision, papakita lang natin. Ayan, ayaw bumalik. Yan po yun. Ayan. So yan, this is a residential credits. This is from a grab yata, screen grab doon sa internet. Credits to the owner na rin. Ayan. This is for academic discussion lang po. Okay, yan. Residential subdivision din ha. Imagine that. Mayroong mga commercial establishment. Eh, kung sino-sino yung pumapasok. Kasi nga, ang dami mga residential establishment doon. May mga nightclubs pa. Gustong-gusto ni... yung mga ni Sir Lando Ubanyana, yung mga hindi naman yung mga nightclubs, yung mga ganito, yung mga restaurant, gustong-gusto ni Sir Lando Ubanyana o Valencia yan. Yan, may nightclubs pa. Yan. Oh, yun, may mga vendors pa nga, sidewalk vendors. Yan. So because of this, yan, nagpalabas ng memorandum yung Homeowners Association, yan nga, imposing this regulation. However, yung isang resident doon na mayroong motels, operations of motels, commercial establishment, objected to the requirement kasi nga, motel yung sa kanya eh. Sabi niya, he filed before the HLURB, Housing and Land Use Regulatory Board, the Regional Office, a complaint for the issuance of cease and desist order with application of temporary listing order. He argued, remember kasi, the requirement is for patrons or yung mga papasok doon sa subdivision to leave their ID doon sa guardhouse. So parang, natatakot yata yung mga patrons na this is unnecessary regulation daw, siguro. He argued that the policy was invalid. Ito yung argument niya, however. Remember, his commercial establishment are motels, so you know, we cannot speculate, but he argued this way that the policy of the homeowners was invalid because the subdivision roads have been donated to the city, to the LGU. Donated na pala itong roadblocks na ito, so this have become public. So sabi ni Mr. K, these public roads must be open for public use. So at the first instance, may objection as to security concern. Later on, nag-raise yung isang homeowner na this must be open to public because nga this is for public use. Donated kasi ito sa LGU. Likewise, he contended ito. Ito na. This is cumbersome to his customer and this has affected his business. Yan. Yun eh. He insists that the policy is invalid because subdivision roads, sabi nga, are public roads and for public use and outside the commerce of men, having been donated to the city, and they maintain that the access and use of subdivision roads should be open to the general public and not limited to privileged individuals. They pointed out that these roads cannot be alienated, leased, kasi public road, donated nga, and be subject to contracts, be acquired by prescription, be subject to attachment and execution, be burdened by voluntary easement, or be under control or private persons or entity, or including hubs or the homeowners association. They further argue that the policy is an authorized restriction on the use of public roads, as it is unduly converts them to private road. Yung pag-regulate sa passage, it unduly converts daw from public road kasi donated to private road and hinder their accessibility from the public and subject them from exclusive control of the homeowners. They insist that the city has the power to control and regulate the use of roads. Medyo nakakalito kasi at the first instance, medyo yung concern ng homeowners ay yung security. Gusto nilang magpatulong. Ngayon, nag-i-insist na, you cannot do that kasi this is a public road. Unduly converting the public road into public road. Homeowners should have had the city government address its concerns. So therefore, wala daw ang karapatan si homeowners na mag-regulate doon kasi public road si city na. Ito na yung pumapasok, yung parang katulad paralysis doon sa mga ginibang guardhouses doon sa Quezon City. I'm not saying this falls exactly at all fours or talagang yung merits of the case magkatulad, iba-iba eh. Yun, petitioners contend that the local government code has conferred to the LGUs, ito, take note of this, sabi ng petitioner to ha, hindi decision ng Supreme Court, yung pag nasa local government code daw, ang authority to of the LGUs to regulate the use of public roads and to ensure protection and promotion public welfare. Ito yata yung Section 16, General Welfare Clause, well before the Magna Carta from Homeowners Association. He claimed, the petitioners claimed that the local government's power to regulate roads cannot be exercised by private entity. Yun ba yun? Mm-hmm. To do so would be a usurpation of the local government's authority, an illegal abdication of the power on the part of the latter, thus deposit that to their and the public's prejudice, the policy disregards the primary right, power, and authority of the city to regulate the use of public road. Therefore, we go back to the issue. Sinong mangigibabaw? The right of the Homeowners Association for security to regulate passage sa kanilang subdivision, or yung sabi dito sa petitioner, siya ba yung nag-claim ng right of the LGU to regulate the use of public road? Sabi pa nga niya, primary right, power, and authority of the LGU to regulate the use of public roads. Kasi donated daw. Ano bang sabi ng Supreme Court? So before tayo mag-proceed sa decision ng Supreme Court, balikan po natin yung mga pa-shoutout. Baka naman may mga pa-comment dyan sa ating comment section tungkol sa ating topical discussion of the week. In the meantime, go ahead na sa ating mga sigaw palabas.
Meron tayong mga comments na nanatanggap, attorney, from Ernest Turupak. Sabi niya, nice topics. Best regards sa inyo, BLGF7. Keep up the good work. Sabi naman po ni Yudesa Rakadag, always looking active and great, attorney Wilbur.
Wow, thank you, ma'am Yudesa.
From APT Sweet Rakadag of PTO Kamsor. Sabi ni Tata Duterte ng LGU Pilar Bohol, Mayong Buntag. Sabi naman ni Feli Baguio, hi, good morning everyone. Ay, watching from Lapu-Lapu City. Good morning. Watching from LGU Pinovista, sabi ni Guzmita Escobar. Sabi naman ni Mari Avi, good morning Artie. Keep safe always. Wow.
Sino yan? Sino yan? Bakit ang sweet ng babaeng yan? Sino kaya yan?
Sweet naman. Good morning
si Artie. Pa, sinabihan si Artie na stay safe? Sino kaya yan? Yan yata yung first lady ng ating regional director.
Sabi naman ni Aloy Agubida, hope the weather is good there po. Aloy, okay lang kami dito.
May baha kasi sa kanila na. Yung...
May baha kasi sa inyo. Dito sa amin, okay lang. Safe lang kami dito. Shout out po para kay Attorney Rigal Oliva,
Senyor, good morning.
City Treasurer ng Mandaue, kay Mr. June Rivera, yung City Treasurer ng Toledo City, at kay Mari Ave, yung First Lady ng ating
Yung nagsabing keep safe, RD? Yun ba yun, Nay?
Good morning, RD. Keep safe always. Wow.
Ayan. RD, somebody is marking their territory na, RD, ha? Ayan. Ayan. Thank you, Nay. Balikan kita mamaya, Nay. Sayang wala si RD dito, makapag-respond sana. Mayroon sanang shoutout back na rin na keep safe na rin. Matutunghayan sana natin yung sweetest love team of online kapihan sa BLGF7. Sama pala si Ma'am First Lady, si Ma'am Maria Abis doon sa second dose na vaccination na rin ni ng ating regional director. Congratulations din po, ma'am. Ingat at stay safe sa galing ng sa aming regional director. Yan. Good morning din sa City Assessor's Office dyan. Sa ma'am si Brooks Sirinio. Ay, good morning pala kay sa ating ALAPC President, si Sir Jerry Mayas. Ayan, Barsinas. Good morning din sa ating City Assessor sa Karkar kay Sir Jeff Bahaw. Sir, stay safe always, sir. alam ko nagbabike ka, so mataas yung system niya, yung resistance, kasi going to work, nagbibisikleta, nagma-mountain bike po yan si Sir Jeff Bahaw. Ayan. Good morning sa inyong lahat. Good morning pa rin kay Cesar Sabas. Ayan, tapos. So, ayun. To recap, yung nangyayari sa case na ito ay nag-raise ng concern yung subdivision sa issue security concern. May robbery daw, may rape pa, bibirong pangyayari. Kasi nga, although they are residential subdivisions, mayroon pong mga commercial establishment din, including nightclub. So, they have proposed, actually, they have implemented a regulation, a security measure na nagre-regulate sa passage doon, yung iwan yung mga ID doon sa mga pumapasok doon sa subdivision. Nagre-react ang isang businessman na may-ari doon, nakatira din doon sa subdivision. Hindi talaga, I don't know if nakatira din siya doon, pero nag-aari din ng isang commercial establishment, particularly isang motel. Sabi niya, this unduly converts the public road, kasi donated na yung residential road lands doon sa LGU, converts it to public private use. Public naman yun. Sabi niya, ang karapatan na dapat mag-regulate sa passage doon ay si LGU, hindi po yung homeowner subdivision. So, ano ba talaga? So, anong sabi ng Supreme Court? So, balikan po natin yung ating cited case doon sa Supreme Court. This is a 2019 case, ah. Bago-bago lang po. Don't worry, I will discuss also mga 2020 cases pag mayroon tayong masurvey na naman ulit. So, ano bang sabi ng Supreme Court? So, ladies and gentlemen, take note of this decision. Kasi, ang dami pong pinupunto ng Supreme Court. This was penned, I guess, penned. Ang sumulat po dito, I guess, is Justice Marvick Leonin, yung ating bar chairman sa bar examinations ngayong taon. Nakasuot si Justice Marvick Leonin na bar muna bago jowa. Totoo yun. Kasi mahirap maipasa yung bar pag mayroon kang iniisip na namimiss mo yung jowa. Kaya nga, pumasa kami sa bar kasi wala kaming jowa nun, sabi. Biro pa nga ng iba. Okay. Kawawa naman. Ano bang sabi ng Supreme Court? Again, take note of this, mga viewers natin dyan sa Kakapin, kasi ang dami pong maipunto natin dito, magagamit natin sa ating navigation of mga LGU operations. Ayan. First, sabi ng Supreme Court, there is prima facie evidence of security and safety issues. So, walang question doon. Even the petitioner himself, I guess, raised the concern na we need to address this security concern. There is no question also that the subdivision roads had been donated to the LGU. And therefore, they are public property or public use. Yan. So, paano ba? Pag hindi donated, ibig sabihin private. Mayroon pala tayong taxation, real property taxation implication. So, sa ating existing rule, segue muna sa ating Mr. Paaw. Sabi na ating Mr. Paaw, yung mga subdivision road lots ay taxable ho. Unless donated to the LGU. Pag hindi daw donated to the LGU, you must value it according to the cost of pavement, yung pagpapagawa po ng subdivision road lands. Magiging exempt lang siya pag donated na LGU. Dito, donated na ho kasi siya sa LGU. Yan. So, the Supreme Court, ito, I would like to stress this one. Kasi ang sabi ng ibang barangay, ayaw naming tumanggap ho ng mga donation of subdivision road lots, kasi this time, pag kami na po ang may-ari ng subdivision road lots, magiging responsibility at obligation na po namin to provide maintenance doon sa subdivision road lots na yan. Paano pag magreklamo yung mga subdivision owners na, wala kaming ilaw, wala kaming drainage, kasi barangay pa ang gumasta. Yan po yung sabi ng ibang mga barangay na ayaw tumanggap ng donation ng subdivision roads. However, ipinunto po ng Supreme Court ni Justice Marvick Leonin yata, yung ponente nito. Mayroon po tayong Presidential Decree number 957, amended by Presidential Decree 1216, which made the donation to the local government unit mandatory. Mandatory po pala yung na dapat yung mga subdivision road lots i-donate po yun sa local government unit. Yan, take note, ladies and gentlemen, that is Presidential Decree number 957 as amended by Presidential Decree number 1216. Mandatory ho yung pag-donate. So it's not a matter of private or public ba yan? Pag ginawang mandatory, eh, automatically nagiging public yan. At saka, kaakibat po nito, ito po yung cited Presidential Decree number 957, yung mga roads, alleys, sidewalks, and open spaces, upon their completion daw, as certified by the authority. Sino kayang authority? It's the owner ba? Hindi na isali dito. Puntahan niyo lang po yung batas, Presidential Decree number 957. Upon completion, the roads, alleys, sidewalks, and playgrounds shall be donated by the owner or the developer to the city or the municipality, and it shall be mandatory for the local government units to accept. Yan, walang reason kayo to refuse acceptance of this mandatory in nature na i-donate daw yung itong mga alleys, sidewalks, at playgrounds. Presidential Decree 957, mandatory ang pag-donate, mandatory po ang pagtanggap. Take note of that, LGUs. Anong masasabi nyo dyan? Eh, kayo sa LGU nyo, mayroon pa ba kayong mga subdivision roadlots na hindi na i-donate sa inyo? So point this out. Again, this is a presidential decree. This is a 19 anong batas to? Anong taon? 1977 na batas. However, this is mentioned in a recently promulgated Supreme Court case 2019 June pala. So this is giving an imprimatur to this presidential decree na valid siya until now. So if donated na po sa LGU, eh exempt na po yan kasi nagiging owned by the government na po yan. So mandatory ho yung donation at saka acceptance. Ayan. Now, the parks and playgrounds may be donated by the homeowners project with the consent of the city or municipality concerned. However, no? Pero no po, parks po kasi yan, parks and playgrounds. So mandatory yung roads, alleys, sidewalks, and open spaces. Yung parks, playgrounds, ayan, gustong-gusto namin ni Noel to, yung mga playgrounds at saka parks. Yung treasurer ng Bourbon, good morning sa'yo. Kumusta naman po yun ating treasury department dyan? May playground daw, Sir Noel. Pwedeng i-donate daw sa LGU. However, this must be with consent of the Homeowners Association. Take note, mandatory po yung mga roads, alleys, and so on and so forth. Pero yung mga parks at playgrounds, pwedeng i-donate with the consent of the city or municipality. No portion of the parks and playgrounds donated thereafter shall be converted to any other purpose or use pang playground. Yan. Now, the whereas clauses of the presidential decree, the cited presidential decree 2012-16, explicitly state that the roads, alleys, and sidewalks in subdivisions are for public use. Ito, this settles it. Kasi sabi natin, yung mga private subdivision roadlots, private yan eh. Kasi nasa loob po yan ng private subdivision. Ito, may batas pala. These are for public use. Batas na po yan ang nagsabi niyan. And this is quoted by the Supreme Court, putting an imprimatur to the nature of this subdivision roadlots. Public use po yan and are beyond the commerce of man. Even for that fact alone, except na yan sa real property tax, public use daw yan. Beyond the commerce of man yan. Both presidential decrees, 957 and 1216, however, are silent on the right of the homeowners association to issue regulations on using the roadlots to ensure the safety of residents. Dito na. Wala daw po doon kasi sa batas. Eh, kasi sabi, public use na yan eh. What about the security concerns of the subdivision owners? Paano ma-address yan? Kasi sabi nyo, public use po yung mga subdivision roadlots. So, What about our concerns, safety and security concerns? Mamaya-maya po yan natin i-discuss sa pagpapatuloy ng ating online kapihan sa BLGF7. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, papasadahan naman po natin yung mga pangasigaw, palabas, pa-shout-out, pa-comments. Ladies and gentlemen, balikan po natin ang ating chief ng Treasury Division, Ms. Jona Nabilia. Paas na, may mga pag-greetings na po ba tayo dyan? Yes, on call yata. Sorry. Yeah, go ahead.
Sabi ni Ma'am Marilo Hatamusa Herrera, magandang umaga. Galing kay Marilo Herrera of Consolacion and from Sir Staff. Sabi naman ni...
Dapat yata nakabarong tayo ngayon eh, kasi State of the Nation address ng ating Pangulo.
Oo, sa dapat no, hindi natin na ano, attorney, dapat na pag-isipan natin.
Kami, diehard kami ni nanay na, yan, DDS. Go ahead, nay.
Shout out po para kay Faye Almenye ng City Assessor's Office of Tagbilaran City. Siya po yung acting city assessor. Kay Mr. Pedro Castrodes.
Perdo, si Perdo.
Ng Anda Bohol, si Perdo. Ito po siya, siya po yung president ng Beaumont Real, Bohol Municipal Treasurer League. May shout out pa rin kay Renfer Oporto Wampot, kay Miguel Magat,
Bugo,
assessor ng Tanaw Bohol, kay Analika Iputina Buo, yung Municipal Treasurer ng Puro Cebu, kay Santiago Nianor Soriano Jr. of Alapico Bohol. Hi, my friend. Good morning.
Good morning.
Nina Salamanya Gumatay ng Municipal Treasurer ng Puro Cebu. At saka kay Emma Go and Sid Caballero. Parte na rin kay Edwin Villanueva. Salamat sa...
Okay, Nay. You're on mute, Nay. You're on mute. Sige, go. Hindi pa naturukan niya ang laptop mo, Nay. Kasi patay sindiri.
so, balik ako.
Sige, Nay.
Shout out kay P. Almenye ng City Assessor Tagbilaran City, kay Pedro Castrodes ng Anda Bohol, kay Rinver Oporto ng Quambot, kay Miguel Magan, Marilo Herrera, Analisa Estrella Buok, Santiago Nicanor, Soriano Jr., kay Abelina Salamanya Gumatay, kay Emma Go, kay Zid Caballero, at saka kay Edwin Villarreba. Ang magandang po, mga
friends. Nay, we have a viewer from Sam Simon Pampanga. Sabi niya, mayap aabak. Do you know what this means, Nay? Mayap aabak. Good morning yata.
Magandang umaga.
Ayan, San Simon, Pampanga, layo niya na yan. Okay, go ahead, Nay.
Para po sa aming mga kababayan dyan sa Ilocos. Na
Ilocos, yan. Marunong ka na eh. Sige.
Imbag nga aldaw kada kayo amin. Mga kabagis, thank you for watching.
Is that the dialect also spoken in Baguio City, Nay? Doon sa car?
Oo, attorney, yung mga Ilocano. Oo, yan. Yan yung tenet.
How do we say na we miss somebody sa Ilocano?
We miss somebody?
Hanggang naimbag lang tayo, Nay, no? Sige, go. Ay, Nay, wala na bang pa-shoutout dyan?
Well, so far, wala pa, attorney. Balik muna sa'yo.
Okay, mamaya mag-Ilonggo ka naman, Nay, kasi you're from Tacorong. I am sure you know, you will verse doon sa Ilonggo rin. Thank you, Nay. Balikan kita mamaya. So, ayun na nga. Public road daw, sabi ng batas. Presidential decree na sinight natin. Public road po yung mga subdivision roads. At beyond the commerce of man, at sabi po ng batas, these should be mandatorily donated to the LGU. At saka mandatory din na i-accept ng LGU. However, yung mga parks and playgrounds, pwedeng i-donate ng homeowners, pwede ring as long as with the consent of the LGU concern. At saka hindi na siya mag-convert into other use. Now, yung na-mention na batas, hindi rin kasi na-mention kung paano yung concern, security ang concerns namin. Security, peace and order, and security concerns ng Homeowners Association. Ayan. Dito, Justice Leonin cited this case na naman, itong tinatawag nating this case, this law, Magna Carta for Homeowners, ang Homeowners Association. This is Republic Act number 9904. Passed on 2010, the year 2010. Section 10, letter item D thereof states rights and powers of the association. The association, yung mga homeowners siguro ito, as the rights has the following powers. Totoo pala ito. Ayoko sanang basta eh na mention natin yung ito, ponder on this, ladies and gentlemen. Yung mga homeowners association daw has the right to regulate access to or passage through subdivision or village roads for purposes of preserving privacy, tranquility, internal security, safety, and even traffic. Oh, ala. Natempt ako mag-relate doon sa existing case. Diba? Kaso lang, baka may existing case din doon. Ayan. On one hand, sinasabi doon sa presidential decree, these are public roads. These are public use, public purpose. Kasi mandatory yung pag-donate. On the other hand, itong Magna Carta Act ng Homeowners Association sabi, they have the powers, yung Homeowners Association, to preserve privacy, tranquility, internal security, safety, traffic, and order. So, sino magiging babaw? Yung public in nature ng isang subdivision road lot? Saan? Balikan natin para public use in nature, public use, or yung the right of the subdivision owners to preserve privacy, tranquility, internal security, and safety. Dalawang batas. Merong seeming conflict. Hindi necessarily actual conflict, seeming lang. So, provided that these are done, there are public consultations held, existing laws and regulations are met, provided that mayroong law at regulation na na-meet, at saka authority of the concerned local government units are obtained. Ito, dito tayo nagkakatalo. Pag ayaw ng LGU na you exercise this right through, for example lang ha, through guardhouses, constructing of guardhouses, sabi dyan, you must obtain authority from the concerned government unit, from the concerned government agencies or units are obtained. Kalakip na yan ang LGU. So pag ayaw ng LGU, gusto niyang, you are obstructing the use of public road, miski public use pa yan, you are obstructing the use, miski private subdivision pa yan, you are obstructing, eh hindi ka maka-obtain ng authority, therefore hindi mo ma-exercise itong power na ito as provided by section 10 of RA 9904 and appropriate and necessary memoranda of agreement are executed among the concerned parties. Siguro sa homeowners at kung sino man yung mga affected. Ayan, himay-himayin natin yung seeming conflict. Ayan. Although, may kapangyarihan yung LG, yung subdivision to preserve privacy, tranquility, internal security. However, item number 3 of this proviso, they must still secure the authority of the concerned government units. Sa tingin ko, kalakip na yan ang local government unit. Ayan. Section 10D of the cited law gives the homeowners association the right to regulate access to or passage through the subdivision, village, or roads for purposes of preserving privacy. Yan nga. However, the law does not distinguish whether the roads have been donated to the local government or not. So, ito yung requirements. Number 3 yung pinaka-highlight ko. Authority of the concerned government units are obtained. Ayan, pabalik-balik lang yata. Ayan. So, hindi daw dinistinguish ng batas kung donated ba to the local government unit ba ito or not. Remember, mandatory sana yun eh. Bakit nag-raise ng punto na ito? No. Sinait din yung Section 16, yung General Welfare Clause ng local government code natin. Sabi doon kasi sa Section 16, included po dyan yung power of the LGU to close and open roads whether permanently or temporarily. Yan, remember ladies and gentlemen, ano yung nahulog? Yung radio ko pala, excuse mo na ha. Tawag kasi yung production team. Ayan. So, nasa section 16 daw, yung power of the LGU to close. Oh, balik doon sa nangyayari doon ngayon, existing sa isang LGU. to close an open roads whether permanently or temporarily. Section 21 of the local government code, closure and opening of roads. A local government unit may, pursuant to an ordinance, ito ordinance yata ha, kailangan yung ordinance, permanently or temporarily close or open any local roads, alley, park, or square falling within its jurisdiction. Provided, however, that in case of permanent closure, ito closure, wala, there must be a concurrence of the two-thirds of the members of the sanggunian, and there is a substitute adequate public facility. No, we are not concerned to that. Yung mga closure sa atin, opening kasi yun eh. Yung nagkakaroon ng guardhouses, yung mga secure, yung mga identification card, iniiwan doon sa guardhouses. Sabi ng isang businessman doon sa case na ito, that unduly regulates passage daw. So ito, the LGU can close and even open local roads. Klaro yan sa batas sa Section 21. More relevantly, local governments may also enact ordinances to regulate and control the use of roads. Section 458, again, of the local government code, the sanggunian panglungsod as the legislative body of the city shall enact ordinances, approve resolutions, and appropriate funds for the general welfare of the inhabitants, Section 60 of this code, in the proper exercise of ayan, general welfare. At saka cited yung Section 22, regulate the use of streets, regulate use of streets, walang distinguish whether private subdivision ba yan, basta streets, avenues, alley, sidewalks, bridges, parks, and other public places, and approve the construction, no? Sila yung mag-approve ng construction, improvement, and repair and maintenance of the site. Dito, yung pagpapatayo ba ng guardhouses, may approval ba ng LGUs yan? May authority ba of the concerned LGU yung pag-regulate to preserve security, privacy, and so forth? So, yun pa rin. Nangigibabaw pa rin si LGU. Nonetheless, sabi dito sa Supreme Court case na to, yan, the homeowners associations are not with entirely powerless. Mamaya na yan. Pa-shoutouts muna tayo. It seems that, ayan, na-close daw yung window na, ayan na. It seems that the homeowners are left without power na kasi nangingibabaw daw si LGU to regulate, to open pa nga, to close pa nga sa mga roads. So, ladies and gentlemen, bago natin wakasan ng discussion na ito, magpa-shoutout at sigaw palabas muna tayo. Baka panghuling sigaw palabas ito. I don't know kasi baka matatapos na rin yung topical discussion. Balikan natin yung chief ng ating Treasury Division, si Ms. John Ann Abelia. Pasok na, ay.
Ayong aga, mga pinalangga na mundira nga nagatanaw sa amon
nga. Abay, get. Ikan. Oh, man lang.
Namo mong kita audience attorney sa Region 6. Pero six? Karon wala lang nagka-check. Wala lang sila nagka-ramdam. Ikan sa takorong sa akong mga amigos, amigas, nga nagtanaw karon mayong buntag sa inyong tanan. So, isang sigaw palabas. Shout out kay Mare Fernandez Reyes. Good morning everyone. Stay safe, sabi niya. Yung city, active city treasurer ng Cebu City. Hi Jimmy Lagura. Greetings from office of the municipal treasurer ng President Carlos P. Garcia. Itong si Jimmy ay naku. Ang dami niyang talent at treasurer. Pagkatapos
ukal pa yan dati.
Ukal siya pagkatapos kayo, ano? Nakapasa siya sa
planning officer.
Dami-dami niyang talent kaya nga. Ben, thank you for watching.
Nasa iyo ng lahat, sir.
Ang lahat.
Wow, mamigay ka naman.
Pero naman kami.
Nay, mayroon na bang nag-share ng kape sa iyo niyan? Eh, kasi dumalang yata yung mga kape natin ngayon. So baka naman may mga mabubuting loob na magbigay sa amin ng kape ni Ms. John na nabili. Medyo antukin na rin kasi kami. Epekto yata ng bakuna itong antukin minsan.
Ewan ko ba epekto na ito? Siguro pag nagkasekto. Pero ipa na ngayon, attorney, ito na ang iniinom ko ngayon. Para, ano to pag medyo may sakit-sakit yun.
Talagang relax ka dyan.
kasi parang mentholated yata itong si Lula.
Tago mo yan, Yay, kasi hindi yan nagbigay sa atin. Walang pabigay yan. Baka naman, oh, baka naman ha. Sige na, go ahead. Wala, may iba pa bang kuan dyan? Si Dan Yanesa. Yan.
Si, ano lang ako kay June Deacon, who is watching from State of Emirates. Sino kaya to siya, no? June Deacon.
Wow. Deacon. Ang alam kong Deacon, yung provincial assessor ng Pampanga. So baka relative niya yan. Ay, gitunson pala kay Miss Gemma Abendan, kina Ma'am, yung treasurer na yung kasama natin, si Ma'am Lenny Katag-Katag. Gitunson sa inyo po. Stay hydrated po. Sino pa dyan, Nay?
Sa kaibigan natin kay Sit.
Si Sit. Sit, stay hydrated at saka vitamin Sit, ha? Tsaka huwag lalapit kay Mama kasi senior citizen na si Mama.
Balik sa iyo, Torn.
Yeah, thank you, Nay. Thank you. Ayan. For the last part of our discussion na yata ito, eh, kanina sabi natin, the power of the LGU would prevail over that. But sabi ni Justice Marvick Leonin, notwithstanding, kasi kanina sabi natin, si LGU yung may kapangyarihan na mag-regulate ng use of streets. Pero sabi ng Supreme Court decision is Justice Lenin, notwithstanding, nonetheless, the homeowners association are not entirely nahulog na naman kasi hindi ako magkakamunit. The homeowners associations are not entirely powerless daw. In protecting their interest of the homeowners and residents, in fact, again cited law, Presidential Decree 957 recognizes the need of the Homeowners Association to protect and promote their mutual interest. It's LU Board Resolution Number 7704. And remember this, mga viewers natin sa Kapihan, Framework for Governance of the Homeowners Association states that associations are expected to promote the security of residents in their living environment. The homeowners policy maintains that public nature of the maintains the public nature of the subdivision roads. So walang question po diyan, public nature po yung subdivision roads. However, it neither prohibits nor impairs the use of the roads. It does not prevent the public from using the roads. So yung daw pag-regulate, pag-raise ng security concern, does not necessarily prevent the public from using the roads, as they are entitled, in fact, to enter and exit and pass through them. So yun palang pag-exercise ng mga security concerns ng subdivision, sabi ng Supreme Court case ni Justice Marvick Leonin, it does not impair the public nature of the road. In fact, it does not prevent the public from using the road, and they are all entitled to enter, exit, and pass through them. One must only, just in this case, surrender an identification card to ensure the security of the residents. So ganun pa rin, regulation lang. Walang prohibition to use the road, public use pa rin. Pero you must surrender ID card, so security concern lang. As stated, the residents and the homeowners, including the petitioner himself, have valid security concerns amid a sharp increase in criminal activities within the subdivision. The policy likewise, yun yung ID, iwan doon sa guard, neither denies nor impairs any of the local government's rights of ownership, kasi donated kasi. Respondent does not assert that it owns the subdivision roads, yung LGU, or it claims any private right over them. Even with the policy, the state still has the use possedende, right to possess, use utende, right to use fruende, right to use the fruits, and use abutende, right to consume, and use dispodende, right to dispose, yun pala yun, of the subdivision roads. It still has the power, again, notwithstanding the right to regulate passage through yung ID, iwan yung ID, the LGU daw has the right to, has the power, still has the power to temporarily close or permanently open or generally regulate the subdivision roads. It must be pointed out that in this case, it is not even between the homeowners association and the local government unit, but it is between homeowners association and a resident who disagrees with the policy. So ito yung sinasabi ko, it is not at all force with yung nangyayari sa mga balita ngayon. Dito kasi, it is between the homeowners association and a resident, ayaw niya yung policy na yon. It is not between the homeowners association and the LGU itself. Respondent therefore is not asserting, respondent is the LGU this time, is not asserting any right against local government. Respondent, yun pa, yan yatang petitioner. Local Government Act on the subdivision road. Neither is the local government claiming that its right to regulate the road is being infringed. Hindi naman nagre-reklamo si LGU dito sa case na ito eh. Si isang homeowner lang ang nagre-reklamo. Furthermore, Section 31 of Presidential Decree 957 has amended on the nation of subdivision roads to the local government was enacted to remedy the situation prevalent at the time where the owners or developers fail to keep up with the obligation of maintaining and providing maintenance to the subdivision. Kasi iniiwan na ng mga developer. Developer yung mga project nila. So, wala nang maintenance at saka upkeeping of the subdivision road. So, therefore, yung mandatory na i-donate yon sa LGU, it is for the benefit daw of the subdivision's homeowners, lot buyers, and resident. This must be taken into consideration in interpreting the provision nation. Thus, the donation of the roads to local government should be interpreted is in a way to carry out the legislative intent of benefiting the residents. Conversely, residents should not be disempowered. Take note, the residents are not disempowered from taking measures for the proper maintenance of the residential area. Yan, balik pa rin tayo sa kalituhan. Sino bang mangingibabaw yung kay LGU na magpag-iba o yung taking measures for the security? Ayan, again, local government code, take note, ladies and gentlemen, can close and open roads. Yan, mas secure authority from the LGU bago magpagawa ng ganito, ganyan. Okay. And then Section 30 of the Presidential Decree 957, they may protect their mutual interest. Here, the policy was not inconsistent with that purpose. To rule against it would be contrary to the intention of the law to protect the rights of the subdivision owner. Moreover, it is a common knowledge that when homeowners purchase their properties from the subdivision, they pay a more valuable consideration in exchange for better facilities, safer securities, a higher degree of peace and order, and privacy. Some may also have purchased their properties in contemplation of the right to organize and to take measures to protect this interest. It would be an injustice if this were not taken into consideration in determining the validity of the policy. In any case, the community's welfare should prevail over the convenience of subdivision visitors who seek to patronize petitioners of business. Take note of this because I think this is important. A navigation point pa rin kung you are presented with this situation. Community's welfare daw, sabi ng Supreme Court, prevails over the convenience of subdivision visitors. Ayaw mo ng ganda ng idea, but take note of that. The Constitution, Article 12, Section 6, provides that the use of property bears a social function. An economic enterprise of persons are still subject to the promotion of distributive justice and state intervention for common good. Yun pa rin, general welfare pa rin ang mamimbabaw over convenience of subdivision visitors. Yan. Hindi na lang ako magkomentary sa puntong yan. Take that as it is. Sa Article 13, Section 1 of the Constitution states that the state may regulate the use of property and its increments for the common good. General welfare pa rin. These provisions reveal that the property ownership and rights that come with it, parang cycle-cycle itong decision. Minsan, si subdivision, rights of subdivision owner itong nag-prevail. Dito naman, si LGU at saka general welfare naman. At the end of it all, Constitution na naman yung sinight. The property ownership and rights that come with it are not without restriction, but rather come with a consideration and mindfulness for the welfare of others in the society. Sabi nga ni Mayor Belmonte ng Quezon City, share responsibility po natin yung use of public road. O sabi na, obstruction kasi. Yung the Constitution still emphasizes and prioritizes the people's need as a whole. Ha? People's need as a whole pa rin. Vis-a-vis the right of the private individual, private subdivision. Such is the case here. Even if the petitioner's rights are subordinated to the rights of the many, the policy improves his own well-being. Iba yata yung application. Yung individual right as against the homeowner. Yun yata yung dinupunto ng Supreme Court, yung welfare. Yan. In Bel Air Association, sabi, it can be justified on legal grounds that a person's enjoyment of ownership may be restricted and limited if to do so, the welfare of the community of which he is a member is promoted and attained. So, depending on how you apply this, how you interpret this citation, itong Bel Air, I think this can be used either by LG or by the subdivision themselves. Pag mayroong isa doon nagre-reklamo, just as in this case. The important thing is, there is not precedent, sabi ng Supreme Court. The Supreme Court therefore denied the petition and this prima facie evidence that there are security and safety issues. Ladies and gentlemen, that ends up our discussion, our kapihan for the episode. Wala pa yata kayong mga i-consulta at query kasi yung account namin for the yung i-consulta to na dyan dyan, wala pa po kayong na-send na queries kaya nagkapihan lang tayo. Ladies and gentlemen, para sa panghuling pasigaw, palabas at mga pag-greetings at saka message na rin, balikan natin si Miss John Ann Abelia para sa message na rin niya. Nay, pasok nay!
Morning! Pahabol po na sigaw palabas para kay Marilo Arante ng ang Municipal Treasurer ng Alugin San Cebu, kay Pares Mundigo, yung champion natin sa San Remigio, at saka sabi ni Jimmy Lagura, yung Municipal Treasurer ng CP Garcia Bohol, sabi niya, wala akong magawa. Sabi niya, more power.
Nasa wala. Kanya, wala magawa. Eh, kasalanan ba niya? Nasa kanya lahat eh.
Attorney Reyes, siya BCLT at saka
environmental. Wala siya magawa. Alam nga naman, i-blame natin siya.
I-blame natin sa atin.
Sir, ha?
Ikaw palabas kay Julius Adrian Chin, kay Ana Teresa Balani, kay Sarah Jane Mitante, at saka sa ating butihing kaibigan, kasama sa office na si Julius Panoy.
Yan.
Lang umaga sa iyo, Julius, and congratulations.
Congratulations, Sir Julius. Alam mo na bakit. Game over. It's game over. Nay, thank you, Nay. We'll see you again next episode. That is our Chief of Treasury Division, ang aking co-host for today. Wala yata si Regional Director ngayon for a closing message. Ayan. So, may mga katanungan po ba kayo sa discussion natin ngayon? Huwag lang yung existing case kung anong nangyari doon sa mga guardhouses na pinabiga, pinagiba. So, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Tayo po ay tumutugon sa mga kasalukuyang pangyayari. Ito yung mga tinawag na current events mula dito sa ating bulwagan dito sa BLGF7. And in behalf of our Regional Director, Director Jesse Dotolero, sa amin pong Chief ng Treasury Division, si Ms. Jonan Navilla, Chief ng Admin Division, si Ms. Gemma Abindan, sa aming Chief ng Legal, si Ms. Seth Caballero, Cardente Caballero, sa amin pong production team manager na kaka-engage ng yata. Pwede bang taking off the market na po si Mr. Julius Panoy. Congratulations sa iyo at sa kayong bayan si Mr. Julius Panoy. Ito po ang inyong host, si Attorney Wilbert P. Tanyeka, saying bye-bye!